What's going on, party people? Captain Zeus here, and I'm back with another review for the HBO DC series, The Penguin. And we're going over the season finale or the series finale. I think it's a limited series, so series finale. But anyway, spoiler warning up ahead for those of you that haven't seen the episode. We will be going into this, and there's a good amount to talk about. So like and subscribe for more nerdy content just like this, and click the bell to be notified whenever we post some more nerdy videos, which we do often. Now, I will say, this episode started off very interesting. I liked the unusual way of the way they did the flashback, because we get to see Francis, or, you know, Oz's mom's point of view when it came to the situation with Oz. Now, the way it started off was, it was like the present day Francis, but when she looked in the mirror, it was her younger self, which kind of hinted that this wasn't a usual flashback. And we see her talk to Rex about, you know, Oz and how she's known all along that he killed his brothers. I was like, yo, I mean, I know you wasn't stupid, but you've known this whole time and you just didn't do anything about it. Well, she in fact did try to do something about it. She wanted Rex to kill Oz. That's a pretty serious way to go about things. Now, she ended up not going through with it I think it's because of all the promises Oz made her. The relationship between the two, as I mentioned in the last episode, was very uncomfortable, way too close. And it definitely seemed more in this episode at least, it seems more one-sided, like on Oz's side, which at first I thought it was because of incestuous relations. I know, gross. But I think what it really was after watching this episode was the fact that, one, he's kind of like a sociopath, and two, it was a form of control. It wasn't that he necessarily was infatuated with his mom. It was more of he felt neglected and he wanted all the attention that he felt he deserved. He wanted to be someone that his mom could say that she's proud of, which doesn't go into the control aspect. The control part goes into him killing his brothers, you know, to get the love that he so desperately deserved. It goes to the point where he betrays everyone to get to the standing that he is in the criminal empire. In a way, it's not necessarily love, it's control that is the reason why he does what he does. And obviously we learned that this was because of the hypnosis therapy, I want to say, from Sophia's boyfriend. I can't remember the guy's name, but he's the one that started this. And we get into the part where Oz and his mom gotta tell some truths. They about to tell some truths. At first, Oz was like very stern on his position that nothing happened. But then when she actually came out and said that she knew all along, he still didn't admit to it, which I thought was very interesting. I thought he would have come clean. He didn't admit to nothing. His mom was so fed up with having to put on a face. She stabbed Oz. And then in her dementia-ridden, hallucinated moment, she falls and freaking knocks. She slams her head onto the ground. I literally was like, dang, that's a loud thud. But dude, I can't believe she stabbed Oz. That was wild. I mean, I knew she didn't like him as a kid, but I didn't think she still hated his guts to that day, and to the point where she just wanted to stab him. Mind you, there was no actual hypnosis done to her to make her do that. There was no drugs that made her do that. That was just her straight up stabbing her own son, which is wild. And we go over to Vic's point of view in this episode, and he's trying to scrounge up the people who said they were going to work with Oz, and they end up not working with Oz. Now, one thing I noticed was when he was confronting the triad leader. Obviously, no one was really fazed at what Vic was saying. They're like, it's a dog-eat-dog world, and we never liked Oz to begin with. The only reason we're here is because of Bliss. But you did notice that the younger crowd were paying attention to what Vic was saying. And this goes into the previous episodes I mentioned, where they were not really happy with the way things were. They weren't exactly fans of the way their current leaders were running things, and they felt a kinship to Oz and the message he was speaking. And it was more so in that moment with Vic, because he was saying a very similar message, and the younger crowd was feeling it, but the current leaders weren't. And Link comes in and kind of saves Victor by, obviously he punches him, but the punch was more so to stop his rambling, because if he would have continued, he would have gotten shot or worse. And so he saved him from that moment. I think maybe it was Vic or Oz or the situation, all the above, really made Link into the key factor into this entire episode and Oz's rise to ascension. Because as much as we want to admit that it was Victor, it was Oz's smart planning, at the end of the day, It was Link. Vink kind of saves the day. He comes over with Oz. You know, he gives him that really, really inspirational pep talk when he's at the hospital. And I loved that. And I thought it was funny because Oz is like, "Did you rehearse that?" And he's like, "Shut up." I was like, these guys are so cute. It's so funny, their relationship together. It's such a good father figure, mentor student kind of relationship. You know, at first you never would have thought it would have gotten to this point with the way Vink started things off by trying to steal the wheels off of his car. Then Oz does a really smart political move. He gets a congressman involved, yada, yada, yada. But Vink gets a call from someone unexpected because Sophia puts a bounty on Oz's head. Now, Link is kind of sus at Sophia's proposition. She's like, "I'm going to leave everything to you. I'm leaving Gotham," which is half true. And Link is mad sus about this. She's literally the leader of the Falcone family, or the Gigantes, as they're currently known. And she's just going to walk away from it all. She's literally like the top dog, and she's just going to walk away from it. I don't buy it. Neither did he. And so he calls Vic. And at first, I'm like, oh, he's double crossing. He's double crossing my boy Vic. RIP in the chat. But no. What happens is when the triad leader goes to hand over Oz, he wasn't in the loop. Link kills the triad leader. And Oz, Vic, and Link kill the rest of Sophia's guys. And they are victorious. Which is crazy because I thought this was going to be like a huge shootout war. I thought it was going to be blood guts everywhere. Nah, dude. It was just smart maneuvering. And at the last possible second, that wild card, which was Link, comes into play. And if it wasn't for his betrayal, I don't think Oz would have been able to come through. So let's be honest, if he would have had the entire criminal underworld after him with that bounty, they wouldn't have survived. No matter the connections, no matter the people he would have scrounged up, I don't think he would have survived. If it wasn't for Link betraying the triad leader, Oz would be dead. I guarantee it. After this, Sophia actually is walked out to this curbside of the lake or of the river in Gotham. And I'm like, dude, Penguin's gonna kill him. I actually thought on the ride there, Sophia was gonna like profess her hidden feelings or Oz would. Nah, they just business as usual. I'm still under the impression that there might've been a little bit something more between them. It felt like a little too personal, this whole situation. They seemed closer than driver-drivee. But anyways, I thought Oz was gonna kill her. He doesn't. He gives her up to the cops and has everything pinned on her, which to be frank, she is responsible for like 90% of the stuff they're blaming her for. She did cause that explosion in Crown Point. She is the reason why the Gotham criminal underworld war was happening. And I guess she is kind of responsible for the drug war and the drugs in general because she was trying to push Bliss. She was the one that got him going. So in a way, she is rightfully to be blamed. That was a smart move on his end because now she's the one to get all the blame and he's clean. He's completely clean, which is what the congressman said he needed to be in order to have his political friends. He needed to be completely clean. Now this leads us to a part that breaks my heart. Oz and Vic have such a good heart to heart. Vic says, "You're family to me." And I was like, dog, this is such a good moment. And Oz freaking kills him, dude. And it's not like I wish it was as simple as a gunshot to the head. It should have been like that. He should have old yellered him. But no, he had to choke him out. And we see Vic struggling for his life. He's begging, saying, "Please, Oz, don't do this." Not to sound effed up, but I get why Oz did it. His family has been not the best to him. His mom hated his guts. You know, anyone close to him has basically betrayed him or given him up, except for Vic. Now, the only issue is Vic has learned everything. He's been with Oz from his lowest to where he is now. And if anyone was going to betray him for bigger ambitions, it would be the guy that he brought up. So from Oz's point of view, it makes sense why he had to do it. It's not like he liked it. He freaking loved the kid. You could tell like they were like brothers. Like that was real kinship there, but in his mind had to do it. And I don't think he would have ever betrayed him. I don't think he would have ever tried to climb the ladder. I think he was just content with where things were. He liked having a place to belong. And I think that's what made it more tragic is Vic didn't have ambitions like that, but Oz was like, "I'd better be safe than sorry." Ah, dude, it was such a heartbreaking moment. And one thing too, I noticed throughout this episode is during a lot of serious moments, there wasn't any music playing, which I think helped with the fact that it's bringing more attention to the scene. It's making it seem more serious and more tense or suspenseful than what it would be with music. Now, granted, music ends up playing in the background, especially in this scene, but I think that the lack of a soundtrack in this episode really played a part into making this a lot more gripping than normal Penguin episodes. But in the end, we see the Penguin gets away with it. The Penguin, he gets the penthouse view that he's said he was gonna get. He has his mom, who is a vegetable. She has her own room there, which is weird. I don't know why he still keeps keeps her around. I think it's secretly because he wants her to wake up and give her approval. I think it's because he's really looking for that. And we had a weird ending because he has his girl pretend to be his mom, basically. Just be and say that she's proud of him, she loves him, etc. in the same dress that his mom wore. Now, I thought he was going to do that and then he was going to kill her because he knew the only way Sophia would have found out where they were is because of her. But he didn't. I'm telling you, though, he should have. I think that would have been a crazy good ending. But he should have done that, and he didn't. So it makes me question where Penguin's sanity is in this moment. He's basically lost everything, but he's also gained everything. He's gained all the goals that he wanted. He has everything he wanted, but he lost the people important. He doesn't feel that he's close to anyone or safe anymore. So it's a really big give and take here. And Colin Farrell has mentioned in an interview that by the end of the show, like, he's not one to be liked. He's someone to be hated. And I could see that point of view. I don't think I hate him, though. I think I actually like his character more now because of this show than I did because of the Batman movie. Now, we are going to see the Penguin in the Batman movie, the next one. And I think he's also signed on for the third movie as well, because it is going to be a trilogy. But this is, what an addition to the crime saga that this was. Such a fantastic show. Sony needs to take notes, because this is how you make a show of a villain without the hero being in it. Batman wasn't mentioned, like, mentioned once in the beginning, but everything else had nothing to do with him. The only reason we knew it was still a Batman show is because his name was the Penguin and because the bat signal popped up at the end. That was it. Otherwise, you could have fooled anyone to this just being a regular crime series. And this was just such a good show. I'd probably rate this episode a solid 9 out of 10. I'd probably rate it a 9 out of 10. I want to give it a 9.5, but I feel like there were some moments with the ending, for example, that could have been better. I thought this was just very well executed, though. The series as a whole, I would rate a 9.5 out of 10. It was very good. I would watch this again in a heartbeat. Beautiful soundtrack, cinematography. Photography was great. The acting was phenomenal. Great writing. Just all around a fantastic show. This is what comic book shows should be. Doesn't always need to be TVG or whatever the kid rating is. It doesn't always need to be that. There doesn't always need to be comedy. It doesn't need to be satirical. It doesn't need to be full of action. It just needs to be some very dang good story writing. That's what this was. But what did you guys think? Let me know in the comments below your thoughts on this episode of The Penguin and this the series as a whole. I'm Gavin Zeus, and I will catch you guys later. See you.